Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Hybrid DevOps Pros. I'm Ariel. With me is Liaz.
Hi, Ariel.
Hi. Today, we're going to talk about blue-green deployments, how to use Terraform together with AWS APIs. Mm-hmm. So what are we going to see today, Liaz?
First, we're going to explain what blue-green is. What's a blue-green deployment? Let's assume you have a service running. That's the blue one. That's the old one. That's the one that's already running. And you want to upgrade that. New one is the green one.
Okay. So as I'm moving a deployment from version 1 to version 2, mm-hmm. that's the blue-green?
Yes.
Okay.
We want to do a couple of things. First, we need to upgrade seamlessly. Your customers don't have to know that.
So it's an in-service upgrade, no impact.
Yes. And we want to do it in less impact on the infrastructure as possible. Means I want to change and use as less resources as I can in order to achieve that.
Okay, so we have a system running, fully loaded, mm-hmm. and now we're introducing a change into it, and that's our green mm-hmm. deployment coming in, replacing the blue.
That's it.
And perfect.
Okay, so everything needs to be, again, fully automated because we're not humans doing that, our CI/CD system is doing it.
It's all infrastructure as code.
Okay, so we got to use two secrets here. One is called auto-scaling group, and the other one is elastic load balancer. And Symphony, they're totally integrated into each other, and this is the secret sauce.
Fantastic. So let's see that in action.
Let's see that in action. I have already things already deployed. So I'm using the very simple architecture of, I have a VPC, it's called the blue-green example. To that VPC, I have one route table, one subnet, nothing special here, and an auto-scaling group, which I connected into a load balancer. Elastic load balancer, and that auto scaling group is now spawning two instances, and those instances are showing me this beautiful website saying what is the version and what is the instance.
Okay,
so I just want to mention I'm seeing here the two instances because I disabled cookie stickiness. We have that already, and if I would do that, I would only see one.
Yeah, of course. I mean, if you have sticky sessions, yes. then the load balancer is going to send you yes. always to the same
exactly.
place.
Okay. Okay. So, and the viewers were going to say, you're going to have only one instance. So no, we have several instances, and they're all running. Okay, so now I'm having those instances, and what I want to do is I want to change the version.
Okay, let's upgrade them.
Okay,
yes.
So let's upgrade. The upgrade is going to be very simple. I'm just going to change 1 to 2, and I'm going to apply it. And going back to the architecture, I'm going to explain exactly what's going on here. What I did in Terraform is I told Terraform I'm changing, in this specific case, the cloud init config. Terraform says, okay, the instances, okay, the profile of the instances connecting to the auto-scaling group has changed. That means I need to change the auto-scaling group. The secret sauce here in Terraform is to mark it in create before you destroy.
I see. So that would cycle the instances,
exactly.
create a new one,
exactly.
remove the old one.
Exactly. So the first secret sauce is, I'm going to, let's just view that as we go. So we're going to see the version change eventually. Auto-scaling group came up. Now it's being recreated. So I have the old auto-scaling group already connected to the load balancer. And I've got a new auto-scaling group coming up with the new version.
Got it. So the new instances are coming mm-hmm. up under a new auto-scale group.
Exactly. So Symphony with Terraform is now connecting both auto-scaling group to the same load balancer. In this specific case, what's going to happen is that the users are going to experience two versions. But in microservices architecture, in our cloud solution architecture, obviously you need to cater for both versions. Okay, so it needs to be backward compatible, but mm-hmm. this goes without saying. So now once the auto-scaling group, the new one comes up, we need to remove the old one. Now comes the second secret sauce. The fact that we're integrated into the elastic load balancer because we have the health check already integrated into the load balancer. So the health check now will ask, am I ready? Are the new instances ready? And when they are ready, it's gonna mark the new auto-scaling group as successful and kill the old one, and that's seamlessly. So we see that it's already running here. Sorry. It's already running here, the new auto-scaling group. And eventually, you'll see that the new version 2 will come up and will service the the customers.
So when we're looking at it from a network diagram perspective, mm-hmm. we're going to see new entities popping up. We're going to see another autoscale
yes.
group.
So what you're going to see is that I'm going to have the old instances, and I will have instantaneously something like double the number of instances, because that's the new one and the old one. Now, what I allowed here is, because I don't want too much pressure on my system, that's a test system, I said, okay, I allow a minimal size of autoscaling group to come up.
I see. And I think the system is starting to cycle.
Yeah, so the system now, you see more and more.
We saw another autoscaling
group. Yeah, you
group
see more autoscaling group, and eventually you'll see version 2, just like here. Okay, so it came up, and it will start cycling between the instances. So as you see, while we were talking, we seamlessly
transitioned
the version.
From version 1 to version 2.
Yes, and actually I did it now manually, but obviously our viewers will do it using an automated CI/CD
pipeline. Great. Now, Liaz, I saw you using Terraform for all these examples. Mm-hmm. Where can our viewers see these examples for themselves?
Well, as usual, all our examples are in our GitHub public repository. This is stratoscale/strato-aws-examples. So don't forget to star the repository. You're most welcome to go ahead, fork it, clone it, and use it.
Fantastic.
And also the YouTube channel. So don't forget to share and like this video.
So again, if you'd like to continue to learn about DevOps and what's happening in the private cloud world, continue to follow us, and we'd love for you to subscribe. So we've just seen how to take advantage of an autoscale group and an elastic load balancer to create a blue-green deployment using Terraform and AWS APIs on Symphony. Thanks, Liaz.
Thank you very much, Ariel.